Now, let us begin our class with Brahmanad. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Good morning, children. Welcome you all to the remaining part of the last unit, that is unit 3 of the lesson After 20 Years by O. Henry. Let me begin the class by asking you a question. How long did the man from the West wait? After the departure of the police officer from him, he had to wait 20 minutes more to find another tall man come to him. But actually the man who had come to him at 10:45 p.m. was not his friend Jimmy Wells. The tall man who had come to him at 10:45 p.m. was a plainclothes police officer. He was, in fact, sent there by Jimmy Wells to collect some more information from him and arrest him. But the man from the West was quite ignorant about the tall man as he came to him as Jimmy Wells. So he took him as Jimmy Wells and disclosed all the confidentials before him. What was the weather then? The weather was unfavorable, as cold breeze was blowing and the drizzle was thickening. So the people who were on the road, of course only a few people were there on the road, but they all went to their homes quickly. So the road was depeopled due to bad weather. Now let us go through the remaining part of this unit. The two men started off the streets at the police officer, who pretended himself as Jimmy Wells, said to the man waiting near the doorway of the hardware store, "Why will we stand and talk about our past? Let us move around and have our charts of old time." So both Bob and the plainclothes official who pretended himself as Jimmy Wells started off the streets. And while walking in the streets, they walked very close, arm in arm. The man from the West. And who are the men from the West? The man from the West was no other than Bob. The man from the West somewhat puffed up by success. Puffed up means filled with joy, or felt very proud by his success. See, after going to Chicago, he indulged himself in criminal activities. He indulged himself in printing counterfeit notes and earned a lot of money. So he was feeling proud of himself while talking with the plain cloth police officer. So the man from the west, somewhat puffed up by success, was talking of his possessions, and he went on disclosing whatever properties he had possessed. He went on speaking of his possessions. He was talking of his possessions and of his important friends in Chicago. At the same time, he disclosed the names of other criminals who were close to him and who were indulged in printing counterfeit notes and who were indulged in all illegal activities. So in the course of conversation, Bob, somewhat puffed up by success, was talking of his possessions and of his important friends in Chicago and other places. The other, and remember my children, the other was not Jimmy Wells, the friend of Bob. The other was the police officer who came there in disguise as Jimmy Wells. So the other, covered with his overcoat, was listening with rapt attention. And rapt means, remember, rapt means deep attention. And he was listening. That police officer was actually not Jimmy Wells, was listening everything attentively. And he was listening with deep attention. The other, covered with his overcoat, was listening with rapt attention. They had not taken a good look at each other's face. Yes, both the men had not taken a look. Here, look is used as a noun. Had not taken a good look. See, a article is there, then good, adjective is there. So look is used before an adjective and an article. Thus, it does the work of a noun. So both Bob and that plainclothes officer had not yet taken a good look at each other's face. But remember, my children, when the man waiting near the doorway of the hardware store lighted or struck the match and lighted his cigar, Jimmy Wells, the first one who had come there as police officer, had seen his face. And he found that it was the face of the criminal wanted in Chicago, because he had pale face, square jaws, deep dark eyes, and a white scar near the right eyebrow. Of course, that police officer was Jimmy Wells. He also recognized the man waiting near the doorway of the hardware store was his own friend, with whom he had made a promise or a commitment some 20 years before. But the plainclothes officer who came at 10:45 p.m. had not taken the look of Bob, and Bob had also not taken the look of his friend Jimmy Wells. Clear? And when they came near a medicinal store, they had not yet taken a good look at each other's face. They neared a medicine store that was lighted brilliantly with electric lights. And when they neared a medicine store, both of them turned simultaneously. Simultaneously means what? Simultaneously means at the same time, to gaze. G-A-Z-E. Gaze means look. To look at the other's face. As they had not taken the look of each other's face, what did they do when they neared a medicine store lighted brilliantly with electric lights? When they came near a medicine store that was lighted brilliantly with electric lights, both of them turned to each other to have a glance, to have a gauge of each other's face. The man from the west stopped suddenly. The man from the west could see the face of the other and could identify that he was not his friend Jimmy Wales. So what did he do? He separated himself. He was walking close, very close, arm in arm to that man whom he thought was his friend Jimmy Wales. The man from the west stopped suddenly, let go the other's arm, and he allowed go the other's arm. You are not Jimmy Wales, separating himself from the man. He said, you can't be Jimmy Wales. You are not Jimmy Wales. You are not Jimmy Wales. He faltered. He faltered means here talked. T-A-L-K-E-D. Talked in a hesitating manner. Talking hesitatingly. He said, no, you can't be my friend Jimmy Wales. And you are not Jimmy Wales. Yes, I confess, I admit. 20 years is a long time, but not long enough to change a man's sharp nose to a flat nose. My friend Jimmy Wales had a sharp nose, but you don't have a sharp nose. You have a flat nose. Yes, 20 years is a long time. It can make a man grow some 10 centimeters tall, but it cannot turn a sharp nose into a flat nose. So you are not my friend, you are not Jimmy Wales, and I did not make any commitment with you some 20 years before. You are pretending as if you were my friend. No, you are not my friend. You are not Jimmy Wales. This was what said by the man from the west. And what was the name who came from the west and waited near the doorway of the hardware store? His name was Bob. And this was said by Bob to the tall man who had come to him as Jimmy Wales. It sometimes changes a good man into a bad man, said the tall man. He's now exposed before the man from the west, or before Bob. So he said to Bob, that police officer who had come in disguise as Jimmy Wales, said to Bob, it sometimes changes a good man into a bad one. It changes sometimes a good man into a bad one. See, some 20 years ago, Bob was a good person. Bob was not a criminal. Bob was not indulged in printing the counterfeit notes. But this time period, or this time, 20 years time, has turned a good man into a bad man. When this time can change a good man into a bad man, why not a sharp nose can't be changed into a plotted nose. It sometimes changes a good man into a bad man, said the tall man. You have been under arrest for 10 minutes. And he said, you have been under arrest for 10 minutes. So he reached there, the tall man. When he came to that man or to Bob, he arrested him that time itself. So he said, you have been under arrest for 10 minutes. Bob, or whatever your name is, that does not matter. But you have been under arrest for 10 minutes. The commissioner of police, Chicago, longs. Here long is used, not an adjective, but long is used as a verb. And remember my children, when long is used as a verb, it means wishes or wants. The commissioner of police, Chicago, wants to have a conversation, wants to have a chat, wants to have a talk with you in connection with some bundles of $5 notes which have come his way. So some counterfeit notes, some fake notes had come to the hands of the police commissioner of Chicago, and he wants to have a chat with Bob in that connection. So the police officer who had come to Bob as Jimmy Wells said to him that the commissioner of police Chicago wants to have a talk with you in connection with some bundles of $5 notes which have come his way. So please do not play any trick. Don't play with me. Come quietly. And no tricks. Before we go to the station, here is a note I was asked to give. He was asked to give a letter, a note to the man from the West, that is to Bob. So he said, I was asked to give you a note. So before going to the police station, before we go to the station, means police station, take the note which was said to me to be given to you. And it is from Assistant Sub-Inspector Jimmy Wells. And the note is from Assistant Sub-Inspector. Assistant Sub-Inspector, ASI, Jimmy Wells. So, the friend of Bob, Jimmy Wells, had sent a note or a letter through that plain cloth officer. And he also requested to hand over that letter to Bob. The man from the West unfolded, opened the little piece of paper that was handed to him. His hand was fixed, his hand was steady when he began to read. But it trembled. His hands started trembling a little by the time he had finished the letter that was written to him by his friend Jimmy Wells. The note was not long. The note was rather very short. And what was written in the note? It was written in the note that, Bob, I was at the appointed place on time. So his friend Jimmy Wells was at the appointed place on time. He had reached on the appointed place punctually on time. But when you struck the match to light your cigarette, I saw it was the face of a man I did not see the face of my friend, but I saw it was the face of a man wanted in Chicago. Somehow, I could not do it myself. Somehow, I could not arrest you. I could not arrest you myself. I could not do it myself. So I went around and got a plainclothes policeman and sent a plainclothes policeman to do the job or to arrest you. See, what have you understood? Here, devotion to duty trumps over personal relationship. His devotion to duty, that means Jimmy Wells' devotion to duty, wins over his personal relationship. He would have arrested, but he did not do so. But he did not let him go out of the hands of the police. He went to the police station and sent another police officer and got him arrested. So we should give priority to our duty. We should devote ourselves to our duty. So devotion to duty trumps over personal relationship. Now let us have some discussions. When did Bob realize that tall man he had met was not Jimmy Wells? When did Bob realize that the tall man he had met was not Jimmy Wells? First of all, he suspected, finding him 10 centimeters taller, because 20 years before he was not so tall. Jimmy Wells was not tall, but he did not suspect at that time. He thought 20 years is a long time, and during this time a man can be 10 centimeters taller. But when they found each other's face near a medicine store that was brilliantly lighted with electric lights, he could see the face of who? His friend. He could see the face of the man and got himself confirmed that he was not Jimmy Wells. He was not his friend, because the man had a flat nose, but his friend Jimmy Wells had a sharp nose. Of course, 20 years is a long time. That can make a man grow taller, but that cannot change a sharp nose into a flat nose. So he said with confidence that he could not be his friend Jimmy Wells. So Bob realized that the tall man he had met was not Jimmy Wells when he was able to see the face of the man near a medicine store that was lighted brilliantly with electric lights. Why did Jim get Bob arrested? Because he gave preference to his devotion to duty. He could have allowed his friend Bob go from Chicago, but he did not do so. He collected more information about the criminals from his friend, then sent another policeman to get some other information from the criminal, at the same time to arrest him. So Jimmy got Bob arrested. Jimmy got Bob arrested because he was no more than a criminal. As he was a criminal, he did not want him to escape from the hands of the police. He wanted that he should be caught red-handed. That was the reason why he sent another police officer to collect some more information about the criminals and got him arrested. Did Jimmy Wells keep his appointment with Bob after 20 years? Jimmy Wells kept his appointment with Bob after 20 years. He reached there at the appointed time, at the appointed place on time. What consideration did he show for his old friend? Only one consideration he could show for his old friend. That was not arresting by himself, but he made him arrested by another police officer. He could have arrested, but he could not do so. But he did not also allow the criminal go out of the hands of the police. So he sent another police officer to that place and got him arrested. So you are all advised to answer all the questions of the units. Unit 1, Unit 2 and Unit 3. In our next class, we will go through the poem, The Inchcape Rock.